In this episode, we will cover the deny public network access setting for Azure SQL Database and how it compares if you're using the public endpoint versus the private endpoint to connect. This week on Data Exposed. Welcome back to Data Exposed. I'm Anna Hoffman, and today I'm joined by Rohit Nayak, a program manager on the Azure SQL security team. Welcome back again, Rohit. You know, we're so happy to have you here.
Thank you, Anna. Happy to be here and to talk some more about network security features.
Yeah, awesome. So in the last episode that we had you on, we talked about Azure Private Link for Azure SQL Database. And today, I think, you know, you wanted to kind of break it down for us how you deny public network access.
Correct. So let me share my screen here and bring up a slide. So where we left off last time was, customers have the ability now to connect to SQL database over private link, which logically leads to the next question, which is, hey, now I have private connectivity. How do I shut down public connectivity to my databases? So for this, we have introduced a new knob, if you will, at the server level. It's called deny public network access. And you simply switch it to yes, and it'll deny all public access. Now, it looks simple, right? But let me take you through some subtleties of how it actually works behind the scenes. So today, when you connect to SQL database, this is my SQL database server here at the bottom. And then if I have an incoming connection from a client, the default is I'm not denying public network access, which means this connection goes through the various network access controls that we have spoken about in the past. Like, first we'll check if, hey, does this match any VNet firewall rules? If not, then I go check against my database level firewall. And finally, I check against my server level firewall. So this is kind of how the connection flows through today. So let me bring up my slide deck here. And this is the setting that we have introduced at a server level that allows you to deny public network access. So by doing this, what you're doing is you're going exclusively to the use of private endpoint. Now, it looks very simple here when I show you, but let me take you through how this works in practice. Today, when you log into your server, basically deny public network access is set to no, which is the default. And this means that your connection goes through several different checks. We first check if your login matches anything that we have in the VNet firewall rules. If that does not match, then we check the database level firewall and finally the server level firewall. So this is how your login is processed today. With this new setting, what happens is if you choose to set it to yes, then your connection goes through a private endpoint, and then all this other modes of connecting to the database are taken away. So that is the big decision that you have to make as a customer, is which is the route you want to choose for your connections to the database, and choose one or the other.
Awesome. Thanks, Rohit. That's really interesting. And, you know, one thing that I noticed on that slide you showed is that now we're server scoped kind of only. So when we look at private endpoint, just to clarify, there's no such thing as having a server level or a database level. Is that right?
Correct. All these settings are at the server level. In fact, I will go now demonstrate this with one of the servers that we've been using for our demos. So this is my server for which I have private endpoint enabled. So because this private endpoint is showing as approved, what that means is I can now connect to my server and all either databases or Synapse Analytics workspaces that are hosted under the logical server, I can connect using this private endpoint. And this is what we had shown in the previous video. Here we are in the portal. And as you can see, under the firewalls blade, we have this deny setting set to no. Let me show you what happens when I try to connect to my database in this state. I'm just using our favorite SQL CMD utility. And as you can see, I'm getting an explicit error message here saying that my client with this IP is not allowed access. So this means I'm still coming in via the public endpoint, and I'm going to the phase where the firewall rules are being evaluated, and it's rejecting my connection because I'm not in the firewall rules. Now let's see how this changes when I flip this setting to yes.
Now, one question here, Rohit, is when we flip this to yes, that means that if we're not using the private endpoint, we're going to be blocked from connecting. So is that something we need to be aware of, or are there anything, you know, we're working on around that?
Yes, so that's a good question, Anna. So this is a very important setting as far as connectivity is concerned. And we only want customers to set this to yes when they are using private endpoints. Right? In fact, we have an enhancement coming that will actually block you from setting this to yes if you do not have any private endpoint connections, because then essentially you are disconnecting all open connections to your database. So yes, that's a very good point that you have to do this with care, and you have to know that all your connections are first coming in via private endpoints and only then cut off public connectivity.
Gotcha.
And then you'll see how this changes now. So I get a different error message. It says the public network interface is not accessible. To connect to this server, use private endpoints from inside your VNet. So it's a very clear message telling me that, look, you are trying to connect from outside, but I'm not even going to go evaluate the firewall rules. I'm just denying your connection because of this particular setting. So again, the value add here is you have already defined private endpoint connectivity, and with this, you explicitly disallow all other modes of connecting to your database. So we hope that customers find this useful, and this gives them confidence in using private endpoints and improving their security posture overall.
Awesome. Thanks, Rohit. And you know, thanks for this really clear explanation. I think it's going to help a lot of our viewers when they're trying to navigate, okay, now I set up private endpoint, how do I deny public network access? And how is that different from what I was doing before with public endpoint? So thanks again, Rohit, for being here with us on the show. Viewers, we hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, please give it a like or a comment or subscribe to our channel. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.